I had recently spent 3 years with my stepfather, watching him go through Alzheimer's, the final stages of Alzheimer's. He had to be in a memory facility, and we'd go to see him on a regular basis, and I would see the deterioration and the sad state that he ended up in. And he finally died there in about 2015 at 92. And about that time, in the mail, or maybe it was on the internet, I saw an advertisement for a meeting of Compassionate Choices to celebrate the recent passage of the End of Life Option Act in California. So I thought that's a great thing to do. Get involved in the Right to Die movement. Let's go celebrate the End of Life Option Act. So I went out to the get together, and it was a wonderful get together, really. Compassionate Choices had a lot of people that showed up, and we all celebrated what was unquestionably a major achievement, which was the passage of California's End of Option Life Act, which permitted people who had a terminal condition to get medical aid and die under certain circumstances. But while I was at that get together, I ran into a woman by the name of Faye Gersh. And Faye Gersh, it turned out, was also the president of the Hemlock Society in San Diego. And she also was celebrating the End of Life Option Act, but she said, but it has so many limitations. And I thought, who is this negativist? And then I little by little, listened to her tell me what the limitations were, and a light went on. Bingo! She's right. That's too limiting. And she invited me to come to a meeting of the Hemlock Society of San Diego. And that led me into, I guess, down the rabbit hole, as they say. And I got to a Hemlock Society meeting, and it was at that meeting that I began to get a much broader view of end-of-life issues and the genuine limitations of the End-of-Life Option Act. And one of the things that I liked about the Hemlock Society, even though I admired greatly the accomplishments of Compassionate Choices, what I liked about the Hemlock Society, it wasn't trying to be careful. One of the things that I saw that I liked was they talked about everything, all the options, how you might end your life, in a wide range of ways. And I liked that. I liked the fact that it wasn't just focused on this very narrow legal option that the Compassionate Choices had focused on. And so I got involved, and little by little went to meetings, learned a whole lot about dying, and finally ended up joining the board. And ultimately, when our founder stepped down, I became the president of the organization. So that's how I got involved in the Right to Die movement.